Hello and welcome back to the course. Today we're starting with the very first tool. The first tool is Adobe Color, and you can find this tool if you go to www.color.adobe.com. The rest of this is not necessary. So here in Adobe Color, you have a color wheel and you have a set of predetermined schemes that you can select from. So we'll talk about schemes further in the course. But basically, you can just click around here and see what happens. And then you can control the color wheel like this to change the schemes. And basically, what you're after, the output, is this palette over here. So the palette that is going to allow you to, you can use these colors in your visualization or presentation. So you can fine-tune them here if you want. You can adjust them. You can see, like, because it's the main one, we're adjusting the main one, everything else adjusts as well. And like this, the other thing is follow along. So it keeps it at that color scheme. That's what's important, right? So when we talk about color schemes, you'll see why they're so important. And here, this tool just basically allows you to select a color scheme and then maintain that color scheme. Even with your fine-tune adjustments that you're creating, you will still be able to keep it. As you can see, it's always like opposite. That's a complementary color scheme. It's always like that. Then you can simply just copy the hex code or the RGB code from here, paste it into your tool. For instance, we'll be using Tableau, and that's it. You've got your color and you just paste these colors there as well as you need them. So this is how this tool works. Another cool feature that it has is here you can create from image. And basically what that allows you to do is to take an image and actually borrow the colors from there. So for instance, here we've got a really cool image by Marlena Vera, who is a cubist abstract painter. So this is kind of like in Picasso's style, the images. But at the same time, you know, like you might see an image where you like the selection of colors. And moreover, these are painters. They know how colors work. They know which colors work well together. And here you can see they do work well together. And so you can just select your colors from here and you can, you know, drag them around yourself and pick the colors that you want in your visualization. And like, and then it will, your final result will be kind of based on already a very thought through color palette. Or you can let Adobe Color do it for you. Just click the different options here, colorful, bright, and then just kind of look at the palette over here. You'll see that it changes. You know, muted colors is kind of very, very type of sequential type of data set we might want to visualize there. Here you've got some deep colors, dark, so on. And you might, you know, you might say like deep and you might not like the white and you just adjust it and put it somewhere else. And, you know, you get your color schemes like that. So that's how you can get some colors from photos, and that can be very powerful as well. One more thing that is also very powerful in Adobe Color is you can click this button over here, Explore, and you can go through existing palettes, and some of them have names, like say for instance this one is Inspiration, Freddy, these are people creating these palettes, so you can see what other people are creating and borrow their ideas for your visualization, which is also very powerful, right? So it's like a whole social thing going on here. And, you know, you might think of palettes as something basic, but there they are. People are sharing, people are using Adobe Color. You can see how many people are using it constantly and saving these palettes and from what you can select. So you might find something inspiring here. So there we go. That's how Adobe Color works. And in the next tutorial, we'll move on to the next tool. I'll see you there. Until then, happy analyzing.